Okay. I think we're live. Guess we'll continue the painting. Yeah. It's a bit cold. It's a bit rainy outside. It's not nice. But yeah, good day though. Good day. Good day for sure. A bit of blue, that's nice. Nice bit of blue. Oh, and it came in palette as well. We should put a bit of blue here. See what? Put a bit of grey. Yeah. Secondary little palette thing. It's just an old table that I found in the garage that had a piece of glass in the middle. The glass is perfect. Yeah. Paint. Ceramics, they're very durable. Yeah. You sort of want to keep them clean as well. Motivated to keep them quite clean. Yeah. Hopefully this can work. Yeah. Two viewers on Kick. Nice. Hello. How are you? A bit of white spirit. Just pure white spirit. Pour on the palette. I'm just trying to use it to break it down a bit. A bit of paint there, maybe. Let's see. Your palette is so important. If you make nice colors, let's back it. Use your old colors to mix, but you can never use a smooth surface. That's important. it doesn't limit your colors. If I could, I'd have like a massive, massive palette. Like I'd have just a long, massive tile. Just so you could do anywhere, and, you know, just you literally pick up. You have a palette. It's got little easels and shit. I don't know. That'd be so cool. You just literally pick up and pay. You'd have so many colors going. You could literally have every color all around you. So we'll just go to Tile World. Pick up a few more tiles. I'll try and get them for free. I just like speak to them and say, can I have a test tile or something? Try and get like three different long tiles. I know, try and like, you know, you have to something talk to them. You know, I don't know. Say, do you have just a spare one in the back that you're not gonna use? Don't bother out. You know? You hope. Sad. All the frames have dropped. I don't know why. This should be working. Maybe this is working. Let me just check. Oh, hopefully the frames are back. Where is... Okay. Yeah, I think we're good. Like, okay, I'm just thinking about this now. Imagine you had oil paint. You pour it out on day one, okay? And you move it around. Keep it all good. Keep it there. Leave it overnight. Day two. You get it again. Move it all around. Keep it all good. But you always move it around, work with it. Get it warm, whatever. Day three, you do that. Day four, day five. You keep doing that. Will it dry up? Because if you do it every day, because if you like left it for 5 days, okay, if you did it in winter, maybe it wouldn't. Maybe if you did it in summer, it would still dry up eventually. Would it get harder? Would the oil paint get thicker? You know? I might test that actually. I'm kind of curious now. Because like, could you hold the oil paint like wet, in a wet state for a long period of time if you put your energy into it? I don't know. Does that make sense? I think that makes sense. Or would it dry up after a week nonetheless, even if you move it every single day and try and keep it like quite smooth? Would it eventually dry up? I think it would eventually dry up. Wouldn't it have to eventually dry up? Like that's 2 days and it is a bit harder. Like it is more clay, like let's say more clay. Something nice and smooth. But if I did touch this yesterday I moved it around a bit like this, you know. Do you think you'd keep that color? Do you think you could keep that color alive for a long time? Yeah. That's a good experiment. Write a paper on it. I might do it. Publish art papers on the oil paint. Write long essays. Write a long essay, hypothesis experiment. Yeah. Test things. Ways to make it last longer. Is there any like a natural white spirits? Sustainable white spirits? I'm looking for that. I need some eco-friendly white spirit. That is as powerful as white spirit. I want less harm to the environment, personally. Oil paint is different, I like to point that out. It's all synthetic. I hope. The field around the corner grows all the seeds. Around the corner, I go to that. A little bit of a walk. I don't know how I'm going to do this painting. I don't know if I'm too happy with this front bit. I might try and reduce it a bit. I don't know how much we're going to do today. I want to fix the sea a bit. We've got this nice base sort of coat on. Just wanted to get some colour on the canvas. Trying to play around with a couple ideas. Structure it out a bit. Yeah. Maybe try and put a sun in today, figure out sun's placement, so then we can figure out other directions in light. Figure out the colour of the sun first, that's important. The colour of the sun. Yeah. This is not a nice colour, so I'm going to get rid of it. The music is alright, I don't know. But like here. Yeah. That's alright. Okay. Okay. Let's figure this out. Save the wine because I have none. two boundaries first, then do the inners. Okay. And then another one. And that way it should go that way. To like here. Work. Just need a plan, sort of what I'm gonna do. Let's mix some colors. Oh, I need a bit of a project. What color did you get? Need to figure out sort of sizes that I might try and use to try and make it a bit more precise. I need to get the perspective. That's not the easiest thing. You're not really following anything, you're just sort of going with it. I just want to wipe a bit of paint off the canvas. I have to take away some paint, which I don't like. I see it in a fresher eye now, and I changed the painting a bit. Hopefully the painting's still... it's not the best workable bit, but a bit of white spirit will fix it. Bring it in a bit, push it out, sort of bring in the horizon a bit more. I'll try and get some of this color. Thank you. pull it in a bit. It's probably a bit too dark, to be honest. Sorry for not talking, I'm just sort of in a zone, you know, you sort of get in the zone painting, not really get sort of just in the flow, in the rhythm, and just get a bit lost, you know. Sort of daydream, just paint, muck around. Okay, I need to just put a bit more, fill that out, fix that shoreline bit here. The front, I need to change a bit of the colour there. I just wanted to try and pull it in and see what it would look like. Yeah. I could make it a bit darker at the front, tempted to. I think it would be probably a bit darker. I don't know, we'll see. We will see. I think, too much. I was a bit heavy fingered there. Got way too much red in there. Magenta. Let me get back to that colour again. There we go. It's quite a nice colour there actually. No, I needed a bit more. That's not bad. I'll take that. It's, I That's interesting. Really, I want that color. It's more of it, really. Maybe more of it. I think that's a bit better.
I think it is.
Tell you what, let me just get some white paint. See if I've got Amazon Prime still until the end of this month. So let me see if I can try and get some white paint ordered for tomorrow. Give me 1 second. We need. I go through it so easily. Yeah. I literally get any oil paint they show me as long as it's delivered tomorrow. What day is it today? Come on, you can deliver it on Wednesday. Come on. There must be Wednesday delivery for one of these white paint. Nah, no way. No way. It is a little late, I agree. By Thursday. That's the best they can do. By Thursday. Don't know what we do then. By Thursday, we'll be paid. Okay. We need to contemplate that. Yeah, we just sort of dragged it in a little bit. I mean, like, tired. No. It's alright. Well, it's actually sort of pushing it tight out, really. Could be a little too light. We might see what we can do there. Okay, I'm just sort of trying to fix it, get it a bit more shape or something. Wasn't really too happy with it, actually. Just trying to
rid of some bits. Yeah, I did think so, really. Yeah, that was... with a touch of white spirit. Oh, cut by. Okay. What does it look like in there? Yeah, it looks alright. Okay, I think I know what I have to do. It's going well, it's going well. Okay.
It's alright. Well, I need to put some music, the music for me.
I've been in silence. Didn't realise. Oh, lovely. Right. Okay. Painting is coming along. I just want to change the shape a bit of. I think it needs a slightly better shape. I just cover things up with white paint. Sometimes that helps. If you want to go lighter, sort of start with a bit of more of a blanket slate. With the pop with a snap with it. All my ladies pop your backs with it.
How is that looking? I'm just gonna stand back a bit and have a look at it.
All my ladies pop your backs with it. Thank you. How's that look?
That's not right.
Okay, so I think I've got the shape a bit more how I want it.
I think that looks quite good. Oh, I stepped on paint. Shit. Stepped on paint. It's not good. Okay. Let's have a little break for now. Let's have a think what we want to do. Move a bit of that white, I think, firstly. I feel like that was a bit too much white to put in. There you go. That's a bit better. Dimension and die. Shit.
Okay. You make some more of this blue, and you make a dark blue. I need to darken the sea a little bit at the horizon. So I've just made a bit dark blue, a real dark. Deep blue, bluey green in a way. I'm just gonna put it a bit more to the back. Just
bit more detail in the C. Just a bit more. I don't know, just seeing what calls to me. What parts sort of my little touch over just to make it more how I picture it, imagine it. I'm fading. Who's checking the strings? Is anybody who I'm okay. Yeah, that's much better. Gosh, put more dark there. Moving that up a bit. Colours I went the complete wrong direction with the colour. Needed a bit more blue in it. Not a lot of blue. Just get more blue. And then try again. It's getting the horizon I want. Slowly getting to that horizon. Yeah, how do you think it looks? I think it's getting there. Yeah, it's going all right.
bum, bum, bum. Bum, 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 bum. How does that look?
There's a gap in the middle.
Gosh, made such a dark color. I don't know if that's right.
I think it's going alright. Then the horizon has a bit more glow. I've darkened it.
Okay. Looking better.
What do you see? You see? Yeah, you see right. Yeah.
Deep in the back.
Yeah,
I just like the shape better.
I like the overall feel of the painting a bit better. I think it's a bit, flows a bit nicer now. I removed some unnecessary garbage. I think this is the next unnecessary thing to move, yeah, for sure. I think it actually serves no purpose at all. If it served a purpose, I'd probably like it. We're doing some drastic changes, but I think it's for the better of the painting, really. I think it's just it's the integrity of the painting that calls for these changes. Okay, lovely. Let me just sort these two things out. Boom. Boom. Okay. We're just putting more detail in the sea, just layering up the sea a bit more, trying to see where we want a bit more of the colour, a bit darker. That's fine. You're gonna need to do a shoreline. We're just sort of doing, we needed a sort of white wall of the shoreline, all that, of course, but just seeing. It's a bit of blue there, but let's a little bit. Oh, bless me. Whoa. That's the wind. You hear the wind? She's a bit of wind in here. The white spirit is a bit potent. We'll do it like that for now. See how much that moves. Okay, that should be right. Okay. My hands are pretty dirty. Let me just wipe them.
Is internet working? I hope it is.
That bit's a bit green, like I need to go over it with something maybe. Maybe another colour. Sort of is alright though on the No, maybe I'm over picky, over knitting it really. Just touching up the edge of the horizon. It always needed to be touched up. I sort of left it pretty, blank, you know. I literally had bare canvas on the horizon line. Fixing this horizon, give me a sec, sorry. Just take away some of this excess pain. give me a sec.
Oh, that's good. That is good.
Take that.
Yeah, does that look,
yeah, it looks a bit better. Oh, I've got a bit too much black in there, so I'm going to make sure I don't dilute the colours when I mix. How is that looking? I think it's looking much better. Yeah, okay. I was just trying to fix the edge. I went a little too high on the horizon on the edge. I should have wiped it and redo it. Good thing we're working with oil is you can easily just wipe it off with white spirit and redo it.
doesn't completely ruin you. Make a little mistake. I really shouldn't be using dirty rags on this. Should use sort of slightly cleaner. But I'll be honest, I'm lazy. But I also don't want to keep this the clean rag for my hands. I need to get some more rags still. All of them with white paint, probably. My hands are dirty again. Look at that, it's covered in blue. But I think the sea is getting better. I think that's nice to see. For sure. A bit more in it, you know? Just has more in it. Check something. Let me sit back for a sec. Let's see where we're at. That looks much better, I think. Painting has a nicer shape. Thank you. Sing maybe a sun colour. Having a think with the potential colour of a song. So would it be in this scenario? It's sort of a couple of choices. I don't know which one my gut is telling me to go for. I'm just gonna try something small. That color's a bit dilated. Blue. Let's have a quick
think.
Let's see if I have a picture I took the other day. I just want to see the colour of the sun in there. It's a bit brighter. The sun is brighter. I didn't realize that. The sun is really bright. Source of light. Oh. It's getting diluted by. The sun is blue. So let me just wipe this off. Nice area to work with. And skin colour. I'm too picky. I'm trying to find the perfect colour. I'm very picky with colours. Have to be right. Close to right. quite, my color mixing is just in circles, I'm just making all these different colors. And they're all wrong. It's just they're nice colors, like what's this? That's just interesting. That's sort of pastel. Yeah, that'll be why. My hand was dirty. I just didn't realize my whole hand was blue. So I just put a bit of blue paint. I think the sun is quite subtle. Let me just fix it. Let's check. The corners of these tea towels are really good at just cleaning up a little bit of detail. I'm just fixing this sun.
Okay, the little sun there, oh, maybe it's a bit too small. It's quite a... I don't know how I feel about it. I need to remove it. Just a small little bit of light. Is that the right colour? It's quite subtle, the sun. I think that's alright with that little sun for now. I can always change the colour of the sun, but I like the size, the shape, and the placement of it. I think that's the important part. I'm going to keep it for now. We can always work on it. It's just that little beam of light there. I was like putting a little sun in.
Hello, Huntress. How are you? I didn't realize yesterday that my chat froze. So I didn't know. I didn't see anyone type it. I didn't see it all until the end. It was really sad. I was like, no one's typing, and it was the chat froze on me. So that was really annoying. But halfway through the stream, I didn't know. Yeah, I was really sad. I didn't see any of your messages. Because I had it was raining last night, it was storming, and I have a stream on my hotspot, and I got the other one, the chat on the house internet, so, and the house internet died, so I didn't realise. So yeah, I just put it all on the hotspot, because I know that's reliable, so yeah, I'm working, I'm adapting to changes. Take difficulties. Annoying, eh? Yeah, it's taking shape. Painting slowly taking shape. Adding a bit more layer in. It's slowly building up. Just building up the sea, sky. No more sky. Put a little sun in. And I'll just put a bit more of the reflection in, hopefully I'm just having a bit of fun with it, really. Don't really know where I'm going. Make it a bit abstract, I think. But we'll see. Dinner or something. Grab a fork. I start using forks at 7 p.m. Bloody spoons after 7 p.m. What are you eating? That's cool. Wait, what time is it at wherever you are? It's broccoli at night. 6 p.m. 6 p.m. minus 4 hours. So what are you? Are you east side of America then? You must be sort of east America, aren't you? I must be minus 4 hours. Few hours, no, minus 6 hours. I'm guessing around there. I'm Illinois. Yeah, my American geography is pretty poor, to be honest. I'm not that, I can name places. Let me look at a map. Let me see where this place is. Illinois. See the noise, please, on Google. Illinois. Ohio, Indiana, Kentucky, Alabama, Mississippi. Illinois. Oh, you're central. Oh, no, centrally. Yeah, sort of right. Oh, Chicago, of course. Chicago, Illinois. Oh, yeah, you're there. I haven't looked at a map of America in a while. Georgia, South Carolina, Florida. I've been to Florida. I think I've only been to Florida. Disneyland, of course, when I was a little boy. Okay. I really want to go surfing in America. That's the dream. Probably, you have to sort of, yeah, maybe go to the West Coast surfing.
Why not? Illinois.
What's in Illinois? Anything interesting? What do you visit in Illinois?
The stream to die from the looking where Illinois is.
Okay, lovely. Here we go. It's charging again.
It's lovely.
Okay. Yeah, painting's taking a bit of shape. Cornfields. Cornfields. More cornfields. Love cornfields. Famous for corn. I'm guessing you hate corn. More cornfields. We have a couple of wheat fields nearby, actually. I don't travel much. I'm more of a home body. A home body, okay. Interesting. I don't travel much, I'm a home body. I like to travel a little bit, to be honest. You're probably, have you ever heard of the word troglodyte? 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 Have you ever heard of the word troglodyte? That's an interesting word. I heard it, learned it today. I'm sometimes a troglodyte. I'm a hermit at home. That's the word. A person who lived in a cave. I saw a movie today and a guy describes himself as a troglodyte. It's a great word. Troglodyte. Yeah. I sometimes, when I'm in my studio, I feel like a bit of a hermit in a cave. You know? Yeah. I don't know. Homebody might have been troglodyte. Troglodyte. No, I don't. Yeah, it's a funny word, troglodyte. It's from Greek, I think. No. Do you work from home? Your homebody? Do you work? Oh, my hand's so dirty. George Jeopardy. I've been watching Jeopardy in because there's an American show and they brought it to England. They've got Jeopardy on in at 4 p.m. with Stephen Fry. Yeah. Kind of funny. It's you learn weird shit. And set up today. Oh nice. I'm currently working on streaming. I just got affiliated and set up today. Oh nice. That's pretty cool. What do you stream? What's your, have a look at your, you're streaming on Kick? What are you going to stream? Games or what? A bit of art? This is my third stream. So I give it a go. Let people watch the process. Hopefully I can teach people something about art so that at the end of each stream someone knows at least something a bit more. They learn something about art or painting. Yeah. We'll just get inspired to paint, hopefully.
Let's see what you look. Let's see what you are. Straight.
High kill Call of Duty, I love that. Art and dark RPGs. Give me an example of a dark RPG, please. I need to, that interests me. I like high kill Call of Duty. I think I used to just play Shipment or on repeat and just go for like 100 bombs. Cause that's all that was fun to me. Was that? Annihilating people on Shipment on 24/7. Warzone was so good in the early days, in the real early days. Then it got dog shit. Not that awesome. I don't have the Adderall in me to kill all these people. You haven't got any advice and tips for me, Kent, but something about to me. And it's like, is that in inches? That's inches, right? Yeah, because you're American, you work in inches. Elden Ring, 11 inch by 14 inch. Okay, 11 inch by 14 inch. Are you going to do it a landscape or a portrait? How are you going to paint it? Yeah. What's your art? Elden Ring. Oh, I really want to play Elden Ring, to be honest. Looks quite fun. Looks long. I need to find the time. I have a console to play it on. So. Oh, it looks really good. That's the RPG I'm playing, to be honest. Are you going to stream your big canvas or what? Let me know. And I can give you tips, but I need a bit more of what ideas do you have for the canvas or what. I quite like going portrait with canvases. This one's a bit of a change. I have new paint and stuff. I'm gonna go through my art playlist on YouTube. Art playlist on YouTube. Oh, nice. What music do you listen to usually when you paint? I have new paint. Are you doing oils or acrylic? Do you want to do a landscape? Follow Bob Ross. I think you guys are listening to a bit of chill or something. I think that's the playlist you guys are going this. I like a bit of rock when I do some art, a bit of rock. Water, yeah, water's a funny one, eh? Water's weird. Depends what kind of water you want to do. It depends on what style. Like, realistic water, sometimes it's could do realistic water. I do acrylic at the moment. Oh, nice. Acrylic. I need help with water. I mean, if you struggle with water, then just do something else. I mean, or make really thin, right? Like really thin sea lines. You know what I mean? And focus more on strengths. That's an interesting. You can always practice water, but I mean, if you want to do some cool art straight away. Fuck water for a sec, you know what I mean? Just do like a life water and just do a different paint, you know what I mean? Just stop in sometimes. I always shoot my. I will stop in. I definitely will stop in. I will. There you are. Yeah, I got you here. Yeah, I'll have a look. I'm having a look at it now. I would like to watch you. I like watching people paint. Watching people paint is good fun. Real good fun. I like festival music when I paint. That's good fun. Some EDM dance, that's always pumping, gets me in the mood to paint. Yeah. Yeah. So that one, what about? Yeah, you might have to. You might have to. You might have to. It's water just takes a bit of time and a bit of just whatever you feel like. Mine's quite abstract water, I'll be honest. It's a bit like they call weird oil paint. That's what I prefer personally. As to many genres, I want a new playlist every day. Oh, nice. Do you like what's the latest favorite song? What do you listen to a lot? What's your nice song you enjoy recently? I've been listening to a bit of Pink Floyd. That's right. What else have I been listening to? Something interesting that I've been listening to. I tried a bit of Joe Strummer, but that was Mondo Bongo is great. That's one of the best songs ever made. But, it's listenable. Yeah. A bit more upbeat, more sort of drive for art, you know? Sometimes chill music is good, but usually I'm sort of, I need a bit more energy when painting, you know? I need rock to just fuel my soul. So you're doing a seascape or just, what? Nah, I'm curious about that as well. So you could do water and just... It's all about just colour, I think, with water. But to put an even arch line, no nuts inside. I'd love soulful songs. That's funny. That's good. I'm about to put Nicki Minaj fly for Donos and stuff. I love soulful songwriting and trap rock beat usually. I used to love rock. Yeah. I mean, I just, that's cool. Nicki Minaj. She's pretty cool. Nicki Minaj is an OG, really, I guess, in the sort of rapping. Listened to her when I was in high school, I guess. I think it was high school. Yeah, had a bit of those two songs actually, so I forgot, to be honest. I need to have a look. I listened a lot of Eminem during high school as well. Red Hot Chili Peppers during high school. I like a lot of rock now. A lot of rock. I need some I need a good riff, to just sort of nudge your head to, you know. That's right. Everyone needs more rock, you do. Put more rock on. Just blast it. Put some light rock, I mean, the Kinks are great. They're not as heavy, but the Kinks are great. The Kinks, one of my favourites. Nirvana, that's pretty grunge rock, Nirvana. And that always gets me pumped, gets me going. Bit of Rage Against the Machine, if you want to go real heavy, real, just blast your ears out and just. Yeah. RHCP style. I need to Google that, to be honest. I don't know what that means off the top of my head. Boys of four. Have a little Google. Boys of four. Kenny Chenzi. Boys of four. I need to listen to that. Let me see if I can put it on. Put it on in my app. Boys. I'm on Bing. Why am I on Bing? What? Why did I just search on Bing? Never used Bing in my life. Highway symbol. Who's the four? Learning a lot now. I read Hot Chili Peppers. Oh, that. Oh my god. They didn't click Red Hot Chili Peppers. They did not click. Yeah. Of course, our Red Hot Chili Peppers, now I see it. Completely flew over my head. Far out. I feel so ashamed. Gosh. I wasn't thinking. I was like, RHCP? How come I've never heard of them? Of course. Only instrumental through the voice is good, but I don't really care for lyrics. Yeah, that's fair, that's interesting, yeah, okay. Boys of Four, oh, here they are. Boys of Four, okay. Boys of Four, popular. If you can't hang, sleeping with sight. I learned my lesson, that's what I learned my lesson. Is that fine? Yeah, boys of four. That's it. You're right, eh? Yeah. I'm watching the video. Yeah, it looks quite good, boys of four. It sounds right. I just see what you mean with the voice as well. It's that, 2000s, when were they? 2006 years ago. Yeah, like that, trying to. Yeah, that sort of rock. It's cool, yeah. I'll put them on my playlist, why not? I like learning and listening to new music. Boys of Four. Nice, good rock. That's what we need. Yeah, the speaker's there, that's why I had to lean in. Okay. Oh, it's just paint on the wall. Gosh. Appreciate that. Nice. I'll listen to them for sure. I will listen. Okay. I'm trying to figure out what to do with this painting. Any ideas? Tempted to put sea breakers in. You find a bit of motivation to this. So you're gonna do a seascape for your little big canvas. Is that what you're gonna do? It was seascape, nice and really good fun. I mean, what colour sky are you gonna do? Do this guy. Try and do this. I think this painting, what I ideally I'd love to just cut it there. And just have 5% sea and just all sky. You know, just cut it here. And that's it. I like just simple, plain. I take a lot of photos like that. Just the raw colour. Okay. Well, do whatever you feel like you want to do, you know, you need to just, it's just paint whatever you feel, you know, paint, get the blank canvas and just paint, you know what I mean? That's what all I did, that's how I taught myself, was just blank canvas and paint. I never, like, I watched Bob Ross. But I never like followed him directly, I just sort of enjoyed watching him, it was relaxing. And it was interesting, the colours. But no, I never really, I just got blank canvases, stared at a blank wall and painted. You know, that's how I just painted whatever I wanted. Mainly landscapes. It started off pretty poor, but then, no, they're pretty cool, my landscapes, yeah. Really abstract. Don't be sort of restricted, you know. Never be restricted in your art. Never restrict yourself. Always just sort of, you know, follow your gut. It's usually that's right with your art. Follow your instinct. Really. Just start. Just sort of mindless, just paint. Close your eyes and paint, see what happens. Do it abstract. Yeah, man, yeah, just sort of paint. That's it. Just, I don't know, to be honest. Do whatever you think, whatever makes you happy, really. Do whatever. whatever makes it happen. You learn either way. As long as you learn. So you learn something. Itchy leg. These knives are really good at itching. Itching very good at itching. Such fun knives.
Back to it. I'm a bit stuck.
How long has this one taken? Oh gosh. Let me have a think. In terms of painting, just like painting time, like I muck around with mixing. Actually painting time. How long have I been streaming for? I've been streaming for, I did 3 hours, and then I did about 2 hours, and then this is 2.5. But if you take away like half an hour, maybe 5 hours maybe? No, it can't be 5 hours, that's too much. Maybe it is. I've sort of slowed down this process a little bit for this painting. Just sort of going at it together, sort of creating it as we go along. The little idea in the mind. Didn't really have a big idea. If I have a really like strong idea, I can sort of crack it out one go, but this one's taking a bit longer than usual. But I'm enjoying taking time with this one. Slowly just layering it up. I enjoy that. I paint all different processes, really. I can do fast painting, or I can take a while to finish a painting. Yeah. But the thing is, when you get canvases kind of big, it takes time, full stop. You know? Big canvases take time. You have to always put time in, so kind of very, that's all I got. I think it's good. Yeah, I could do seashells. I thought about it. I don't know if that thing. Seashells. Buried. Seashells buried. That's a really good idea. I never really thought of that. That's a really, really good idea. Thank you. Seashells buried. Yeah, that'd be cool. You can sort of, yeah. That could look quite neat, yeah, some along the, gosh, I need to practice seashells. I have to practice seashells in between streams, so I can get a nice seashell. That could be cool, a seashell, put some shells. What would be a cool abstract way of doing a seashell? What would be an interesting? I would play around with it, seashells. Have a little play. The kind of buried is cool. You do like a range of what they're sort of scattered along the beach. Straighten a line there. Just straighten a line. What's that? Which painting tutorials do you have? Favorite people that you like to watch? Who do you watch?
Let me
kind of curious. What kind of styles are you into? Who do you like to watch to get inspired and learn? On YouTube. Gloria and Journey Young Art. Let's have a look at these people. Chloe Art. Have I seen the Chloe Art before? Oh yeah, I think I've seen her pop up once or twice. I think I've seen her. Yeah, she's very cool. Chloe Art is very cool. Very fun. She does teach you how to paint. Does make it quite simple. Yeah, it's quite good, Chloe Art. Gosh, she cracked it with a good little formula. Johnny Young Art. Let's have a look. Bam. Quick painting. Johnny Young. Oh, nice. I'm finding out also that the type of art I'm saving is brighter than the paint I have. So I need to get some neon paint soon, and just got glow paint to try. Yeah, glow paint, that's interesting, glow paint. I've always like thought about it, never really looked into it. I've always, how to really add a bit more dimension to the painting. It's, you know, have parts glow in the dark. I did a painting on Saturday evening, and I didn't have any glow-in-the-dark paint, but I did bits of sort of crimson and gold and like a yellow in the foreground. It was really dark around it, so in like a really low light, it sort of glowed in the from the painting because of the contrast. So that was kind of weird. So I sort of, yeah, it'd be interesting to really make it glow. Glow is cool. But yeah, neon paint. Like, I recommend lemon yellow. Cadmium yellow lemon. That's really good for neon yellow. And that can help you get some neon greens and some bright oranges. This is part of your key. This is color. Like a lemon yellow, like a really... I think that's how I get fluorescent colours, is this. I only have three colours in my palette, and I create all everything. Or I have four. No, well, I don't know. White, you need white. Gold, I mean, gold is just good. Lemon yellow. Magenta. And blue. Thalia blue. That's all I've got. And that's all I need to make any. Five colors. If I'm lazy, I'll use Payne's Grey to make dark grey, but yeah, if I'm not, I'll just mix a grey out of all of these colours, you know. There's something to say, there's really not a lot of videos on YouTube, so be, that's for sure. Yeah, I haven't yet. Let me know how the test goes, let me know how it looks, and how it actually glows in the dark. I think it'd be pretty sick seeing glow in the dark paint. You do it for some, put it in the skies or something. Yeah. Glow in the dark. I'm trying to make the illusion of glow in the dark.
You got glow in the dark.
That's cool. Yeah, lemon yellow, use it. It's really helpful. I mean, I don't know what bright colours. I think you can get a cyan. I mean, for blue, get a cyan. And get like a alizarin crimson and just put a ton of white in it. You'll get a really bright pink, probably. Yeah, and probably a bit of magenta. You can get like really bright oranges with lemon yellow. I mean, you can get some pretty vibrant colors. Yeah. What's your favorite color to work with? I go through phases, personally. I like a lot of blue, but that's because I'm just I like cash. That's a pleasant color, blue. But it's not my yeah, it's a lot of blue there. But I'd rather not do super a lot of blue. I like a bit of pink right now. Pink's quite nice. I've been doing a few pink skies, practicing with pink and mauves. Been into that recently. They're a bit of fun. Try different colours out each time I paint. I could just try and find a new colour.
Yeah.
Like blue green. Ah, blue green. Yeah, blue green. I think I know exactly which colour you're sort of talking about. I remember I used to have I got once a big pack of watercolours of like, I don't know, 40 colours. And had all the names of the colours. And yeah, blue green was the one colour I actually used up, one of the first. It was fun for making skies and seas. I was just messing around with watercolours. I know exactly what colour you're on about. And that set of watercolours sort of taught me quite a few of the colours, taught me like 40 main colours of paint. So that was helpful. Yeah, just get whatever colour. You get drawn to colours when you go through a supermarket and look at the colour aisle. You get drawn to certain ones. You get drawn to it. Every time I go into a little art shop, I always buy something. I always have to. Usually not too much oil paint, because it's always overpriced at the art stores. I always get the oil paint online. Like little canvases, I always walk out with little canvas or little easel. Like doing the small easels, I find them fun to just put little paintings on. As a try with different kind of art. And, see what it takes me. Blue green, I can make a cool blue green right now. Let's see. A blue green, all we need is a bit of blue. A bit of blue, a bit of the lemon yellow, blue grey, let me see. Oh, that's more. Just mixing it together, you can probably make a nice blue, a bunch of paint stuff. The mini easels and canvas. I've done a couple of mini easels actually. I mean, I have mini canvases, like a really small, like 4 inch by 4 inch, even less than that. Like, how big were these? Yeah, like 3 inch by 3 inch mini canvases, just for shits and gigs. They're good fun. They're fun to have little. I put them around the house. These little canvases. Yeah, they're good fun. I mean. They are cool. They're just fun. I Irish pan, whatever, makes me laugh, really. But if I'm just, you know, doing the small ones, trying to get little detail, or just go quite abstract with the really small canvases. I usually go, I put a bit of detail in the small ones. Quite fun little size. On the downstairs, I don't have any really small ones. Up here, all downstairs. I've got them all over the, all over the house. Thanks for the help, you've got a great stream. Thank you. Need any more help, let me know. I can answer questions about art. I'm not bad with that. Can't see what that, I don't know what that said. Am I blind? It's like a techno emoji thing. EDM music, nice. Yeah, that's literally, that is what's in the background right now. That is following the, EDM music. You like, that's a cool one. EDM music. I like that emoji. I like that a lot. Okay. I don't know how much more painting we're going to do today, to be honest. I'm in the stream for 2 hours 40. It's 1 a.m. And I'm actually pretty happy with the progress we made, to be honest. They are, sort of fixed it a bit. You know, fixed the painting a bit. That's sort of all I wanted to do today. Just fix this up, give it a bit more soul. These are my favorite type beats. EDM. I need a playlist. I need an EDM. I've got one EDM playlist. I just listen to that on repeat. I think Dali Jefferson. He has some hard drops. That's I like him. Let me just, I should fix something here. EDM is amazing. Well, I was in Amsterdam and we went to this place and good EDM. It was good fun. Oh, what was it called? I'm gonna find it. What was that place called? We went to this club, pretty nutty club in Amsterdam. Blew our ears out. They had some great EDM going. What's it called? Escape. Is it Escape? I think it was called Escape in Amsterdam. Is it Escape? Something like that. Good fun. We tried to get into the school and they didn't let us in. Bastards. They said we wouldn't fit the vibe. My mate got so angry. Never seen him that pissed off before. When he's been told he doesn't fit the vibe for techno club. We were dressed so good. I think they just couldn't handle us. They saw us like that. These guys. Way too cool for this place. I really still wanted to go. It would have been insane techno. Fuckers. So instead we went to Escape and had some hard EDM. When we were praying, we were in the hostel. We were in like this little hostel. Like, I don't know, fuck ton of people. And we were just blasting just fucking EDM music. And I was like, shit, these cunts get to us to turn it down. It was so loud.
his funny ass.
We brought a good speaker
and we just,
yeah, you could hear it. It's good fun. Amsterdam's a wild place. Good raving though, good raving, we had good fun. Yeah, you got little coffee shops, they all turn into little clubs. Once it hits like 10, 11, they all just go clubbing. We couldn't find the bakery club, that was sad. We wanted to go to the bakery club where you just smack each other with bread and fucking rave. But, nah. We probably had good fun. Yeah, we, the boys had fun.
Yeah,
the boys had good fun. Nearly got hit by bikes a lot in Amsterdam. Nearly got sideswiped constantly. Constantly nearly getting sideswiped. Lawful. You're just paranoid of getting hit constantly by people just ringing at you. They don't slow down. They think, oh, he's a tourist. He's not going to do anything. You can just hit him. They think it's a game. How many tourists can you hit? Don't ban me from the country, Amsterdam. It's good fun. Okay. I feel like that's good progress. Yeah. I think the painting's improved. I mean, it's just got way more shape to it. It's got more depth, better shape. This painting we're taking our time with. It's a large canvas and there's no rush. You don't need to rush these paintings. You don't need to rush paintings. Every time I start rushing paintings, it gets sloppy. It gets really sloppy. You know, take your time. Worth it in the end. It really is. You take your time with it all. You have to be patient with art. You know. And it's never like halfway through, you know. Don't always listen to. Sometimes it's poor, like shit halfway through. But just keep going, you know. Just keep painting and fix it. It goes through stages. Art goes through stages. It goes up and down the painting, you know. And hopefully, when you finish it, it's on the peak, you know. Because if you start over painting, then it just goes, plummets down, turns to shit. So you don't want to ever overpaint. But it's inevitable overpainting. Because you just, it's like, yeah, diminishing returns, I guess. I think that's just putting a bit more detail. Oh, cool, nice. Hello. Fixing something. I'm just getting a little bit of paint on my finger and just sort of putting indications of waves in the light indications of waves in the sea, just sort of putting a bit of detail in. Just little patches. I think it just needs a bit more,
I don't know what.
A bit darker or a bit sort of something else. I don't know, some spots just, you look at it and you're like, it just needs something else. It doesn't just need to be darker, it just needs maybe a bit more movement or just different direction on the stroke or something like that.
No. Take a good shape.
Hopefully people are learning something from this. I think that's got, if I compare that to the start of this stream, we've done good progress. You know, nearly 3 hours, so in 10 minutes it'll be 3 hours. How much of that was painting? Maybe, hour and a half? Maybe 2 hours of painting out of 3 hours. Nah, maybe a little less. Tough to say how much of it's actually painting. Oh, but yeah, just study takes time. Just build up layers. I am happy, really happy with how this sea is going now. It just looks more sea-like. No, I don't know. It's not really a descriptor, but it does. It looks more, more the colour of the sea. I think that's the most important part, is colours. That's the thing, it's colours. We're standing back to have a little look. Yeah, I kind of like it. It's a long way from when I saw it last. Yeah, I think it has. It has a... Is this going to autofocus or not? Is this going to focus or not? I'm right here, hello. There you go. Yeah, it definitely has come a long way. It's a lot more in it. Got a lot more in it, a lot more paint on it. Definitely a lot more paint on it. And the shape has changed. Yeah. Might just add a little bit of orange on the side. Whoa, gosh. Tools covered in paint. Do you paint with a lot of brushes, or do you paint with knives, or what do you like to paint with? What's your, you paint with brushes, or big, wide brushes, thin brushes? How do people like to paint? What's your chosen technique? putting a bit of this color. Right, it's like a pink sort of. And that's sort of actually quite nice. It's an orangey pink. Actually looks quite nice in the
Oh, that's probably a bit too much there. Well, maybe not.
Just brushes now. Used too small. Just got a few bigger ones as well. Yeah, it's handy having big brushes to cover big surfaces. When you do bigger paintings, it's always good to have bigger brushes. Simple as that. Because you want to be able to blend, you want to be able to do a large area. Yeah, knives are really good fun. They're my favorite. You know, my finger's my favorite. Finger and hand's my favorite, but knives are tied. Knives are good fun. They're just they're easy to clean. That's literally it. I can keep a knife clean for like a year. I can't keep a brush clean for like 10 minutes. So no, I can keep this. These knives. This is like my first knife I ever bought. This has lasted me 2.5 years. I mean, yeah. 2.5 years, I think? No, less than that. 2 years? 2.5 years? I don't know. But look at that, looks pristine. I've kept it pretty brand new. It's only slightly bent. Fuck clean brushes. Especially why I chose knives. And my hand, I can literally blend with my hand and just wipe my hand. But, and you never get the brush back to how it was. You know, I know, but you have to be so tedious and cautious and just so wash it. It's so easy to ruin brushes. Like, oh. They should be cheaper brushes. They cost nothing to make. A lot of brushes break on me. I'm too hard on them. Like the, that metal bit always sort of snaps on me. So I lose a lot of brushes. This is one of my favorite brushes. I like watercolor brushes or like acrylic brushes. Like a polymer, even for oil, just because it's clean. It's a sharper edge if I ever do use a brush. This is one of my favorite brushes, just a nice, simple, just flat one. But like, this was so sharp before, and this brush now is, like, it's more dull. It's a duller brush. But the knife is always sharp. You know? And to keep this clean, I can only keep a couple of brushes clean. I got this pack of brushes here, but I haven't actually never used them. They're bright brushes, I think. I never use them, you know. Because then I have to, like, I like the look of them brand new and clean. I don't really want to get them dirty. You know, I don't want to. I prefer to just stare at clean brushes and not paint with them. Instead of ruin them. I paid for them, I don't want to ruin them. But no, it's good. Always keep your brushes clean if you want to use brushes. Always keep them clean. Always. Just always keep them clean. Clean brush, clean knife, clean hands, clean palette. It's the easiest way to keep vibrance in your paint when you're mixing. Okay. I'm hitting 3 hours in about 2 minutes. So I think I'm gonna might call it there. We sort of got to a stage with the painting where I'm alright with it. I'm alright with it. And next time we can actually properly add detail. Straight away we're going to start off at sea breakers. Maybe a couple of birds. A boat. Like Oz said, might put a couple of boats in. And put detail on the shore. Put a few shells. Buried shells. Make a nice sort of actual defined shoreline, like the water, you know, how you have the little white water on the shoreline, put that in. And yeah, we will, we'll continue next time. I think I'll probably be painting Thursday night. I'll do a Thursday night stream, so not tomorrow night, the day after, wherever you are. In Illinois, yeah. Thursday. It's Thursday for you, yeah. So it's Thursday afternoon. I think we'll continue. We've got to a good stage today. And yeah. It's, I'm happy with it. That's what we got to. We can always change it. Should still be sort of wet on Thursday, so we can manipulate it a bit. But I'm happy with the shape of it now. It's, it's more balanced of a painting. I've balanced it a bit more, so I think it's, good for our painting. It's like future-proofing it. If you fix it now, before you start putting detail in and going mad, and you don't like a certain part, like a certain shape, it's harder to go back, whereas do it while you can. Make sure you're happy with it, and try do not touch the bits that you think are great. I usually ruin the best bits, like, you know, good strokes or good bits of colour. Try not to ruin them, but sometimes you have to. But it's just how painting goes. Yeah. Well, good luck with your canvas. I will follow you, and when you go live, I'll see how you go with the painting. I'm curious how you go with the water, if you eventually choose to do it. I'll see you all in like 48 hours, I guess, or something like that. 44 hours? 44. It's probably less than that. Yeah. Okay. We'll see. We'll continue painting and get it done. Okay. Ciao, ciao. Have a good one, guys. We'll call it that. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed your company, Huntress. That was good fun. Hopefully, good luck. Have a good evening, everyone, and see you.